Thank you for watching, and in this video we are gonna cover how to create a mate between the components by using fundamental planes or by aligning the planes. So when we are creating mate between different components inside of SolidWorks, so there is a hierarchy, and the more powerful of an object you choose to mate together, the more powerful your mate will be between the objects. So as you can see right now, I have a part here. So if I want to create a mate, so what I can do is maybe I can select this bottom face and then I can create a mate. But other than that, I don't have enough options to create a mate. But I'm just gonna tell you there are different options. Like if I'm gonna go into the feature manager, still we have fundamental planes like front plane, top plane, or right plane. So I can use these planes to create a mate, and these mates are gonna be strongest or powerful mates, because as compared to these mates, we can create a point mate or line mate or the face or plane mates. But whenever we are gonna modify our component, or if we are gonna delete the component, so all those mates would go away with the modification or with the deletion of those components. But these fundamental planes, they would be always there, no matter if you are modifying or if you are deleting the components, because these planes were always there even before our starting our sketch. So that's why these mates are really powerful, and I'm gonna cover in this video, and we are gonna create some mates by using these fundamental planes. So suppose like I want to create a mate between the top plane of this object with the surface of this top surface of this object. So I'm gonna go into the mates, and then I already selected the top surface, and then what I can choose is I can just choose the top surface of this object, and then I can click the green check mark. So in this way, I created a mate between top plane and the above surface. I had option to create with the top plane of this, that could be the strongest one, but I just want to take as an example. Sorry for distraction, but if you think my videos are helpful for you, or if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, I'm gonna highly recommend you can go into the description of this video, where you can find my course link, in which I have over 10 hours of videos in which I explain each and every command in a detailed way. Thank you. So as you can see, if I want to create other mates between other fundamental planes, so one option is I can just go and select here front plane or right plane, whatever. And if you think like it's too much, so what you can do is you can just go here into the visibility of, and then you can just highlight your planes here. So in that way you would see your planes all the time here. So in that way you don't need to go again and again into the feature manager and select your planes. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna select the fundamental plane, the front plane, and then I'm gonna go into the mates, and then I'm gonna select this front plane. So in this way I can create a mate. I'm gonna click the green check mark. Another thing what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna select this right plane, and then I'm gonna select this right plane, and then I'm gonna click the green check mark. Again green check mark. So when you are done with by using the fundamental planes, and if you think like these are just disturbing you, or if you don't want to see them anymore, what you can do is you can just go back into the visibility of, and then you can just click uncheck this, and then all those planes are gonna be hide. Or another option is like you can just go into the planes here, and then you can see there is an option for hide or show. So in that way you can show your planes. So these are the strongest mates which I created between the components, because like no matter if we are gonna modify components or we are gonna delete the components, so because these mates are between the fundamental planes, so these are the strongest mates. So I would say like whenever you are creating mates between different components in your assemblies, you should use these powerful mates, and then you should not be worried in future if you want to modify your components or if you want to delete it. And that's all for today's video. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this one. And if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, then don't forget to check the course link in the description. Thank you.
Sorry for distraction, but if you think my videos are helpful for you, or if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, I am gonna highly recommend you can go into the description of this video where you can find my course link, in which I have over 10 hours of videos in which I explain each and every command in a detailed way. Thank you.